Now let's look at a question on belts. The question says two pulleys of diameters 450 mm and 150 mm are mounted on two parallel shafts 2 meter apart and are connected by a flat belt drive. Find the power which can be transmitted by the belt when the larger pulley rotates at 180 rpm. The maximum permissible tension in the belt is 1000 newtons and the friction coefficient is 0.25. Also find the length of the cross belt needed and the angle of arc of contact. Okay, so 450 mm means bigger pulley, 150 means smaller pulley. The distance between the centers is 2 meters. It runs with a flat belt drive. Larger pulley rotates at 180 rpm. Okay, so let us say D1 is 150 mm, which is 0.15 meters. D2 is 450 mm, which is 0.45 meters. Okay, so the larger one is making 180 rpms. So N2 becomes 180, N1 I need to find out. Let me find out V from here, which is pi D2 N2 by 60. So pi D2 N2 by 60, you have pi into D2 is 0.45, N2 is 180 by 60. This gives you 4.24 meters per second. So this is the velocity, the linear velocity. Now N1 has to be found out. So N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1. That's the relation between the RPM and the dia. So N1 is equal to N2, which is 180 into 450 by 150. You get 540 rpm as the rpm of the smaller pulley. Okay, so for power I need to apply this formula, T1 minus T2 into V. Okay, I don't know T1, I know T1 which is 1000, so T1 is 1000 newtons. I don't know T2, I know the value of mu and I need to calculate theta. Now it says it's a cross belt arrangement, so theta will become pi plus 2 alpha. Sin alpha would be D1 plus D2 by 2x. So x is 2 meters, D1 and D2 are already given to us. So from here we can find out alpha. So alpha upon putting the values will come out to be 86.27 degrees. Okay, so when you put the value over here and convert it into radians, theta will be 3.443 radians. This is the value of theta. Make a note of this. Okay, so because we need to use the value in radians for theta. So the ratio between the tensions is this. Alright, so now I'll have e to the power 0.25 into 3.443. This will give me 2.365, and from here T2 would be T1 by 2.365, which is 1000 upon 2.365. So this gives us 422.83 newtons. So this is the value of T2. T2 is known to us, T1 is known to us. We have already found out the velocity. We can use these values in that formula to calculate power. So power would be T1, let's keep kilonewtons, so 1 minus 0.422 into 4.24. So the value would be in kilowatts, which comes out to be 2.447 kilowatts. So that's the power required. Okay, after this we'll go on to the next topic, next part of the question, which asks us to find out the length of the cross belt. Now the value of the cross belt length is LC, which is 2x plus pi into d1 plus d2 by 2 plus d1 plus d2 whole square upon 4x. So you know x 2, you know d1 0.15, d2 is 0.45. Put in the values over here. Okay, so the length of cross belt required will come out to be 4.987 meters. Okay, so this is the length of the cross belt required, and the angle of arc of contact is theta. So theta is already there, which is pi plus 2 alpha. You put in the values and you will get your value of theta. Okay, so I hope you got this basic question on the topic of belts. Now let's look at one more question on the same topic.